Hello everyone, welcome to Tech Successors, Power of Next Gen Technologies.
Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss about Automation Anywhere recorders. So let's start the video. Here we are seeing the Automation Anywhere developer client. So in the top left corner we are seeing the new button. If you click on that, this pop-up window will be open. So here you can able to see three types of recorders. The first one is smart recorder, the second one is screen recorder, and the third one is web recorder. Okay, so today we are going to discuss about smart recorder. First of all, we need to know about the recorders, which is helps to record type of application. Basically, the smart recorder is used to automate the desktop applications. Desktop application means whichever application is installed inside your machine, that can be called as desktop application. Then screen recorder. Screen recorder is used to record the screen. That means it can record all the things irrespective of application. That means even it is the desktop application or web application or Citrix application, whatever it may be, if you go with the screen recorder, it will record the screen. But it depends on the coordinate base. That means just it's can be recording based on the can be recording based on the coordinates, x-axis, y-axis, and keystrokes, but it doesn't look for any objects. Then web recorder. Web recorder is used to record the web applications. Web applications means the application which can be accessed through the browser. Those type of applications can be called as web applications. For example, Gmail, Facebook, Twitter, this kind of application can comes under web recorder. So now today we are going to discuss about smart recorder. If you want to use the smart recorder, first you need to open the application whatever you want to automate. For suppose now I want to automate the calculator application. So now I am opening the calculator here. So now our application has been opened. Now we need to start the recording on top of the calculator application. So now I'm going to click on smart recorder application. So here I have to select the application whatever I want to automate. So if I see here, here I have two applications are here, are there. So one is calculator application, second is browser. Of course, a browser is a desktop application which is meant for access the web application. So browser can comes under the desktop application, but the website can comes under the web application. So that is the reason here it is showing the browser also. So now I am going to automate the calculator. So I am selecting calculator. Now I am going to start. So now I want to perform one operation. So I want to add 5 plus 3 is equal to 8. So I have recorded one desktop application. So now I'm going to stop this. Now it will ask the save window. So here you need to save with some proper naming convention. So I am saving here calci app. So I am saving this. So I am saving it here. So where is this? Yeah, it is saved over here. So see here, it is saved as calci app.atmx. So atmx means automation executable file. Okay, wait a second. Yep, yeah, it is opened automatically in editor mode. But actually first let's test it whether it is working or not. So I am going to here and making it as 0. Now I am going to run this CALSI application. So in the right bottom we are seeing the runtime window. So it's opened the calculator application. Now it's clicked on 5, it's clicked on 3, now it's performed the is equal to operation and it became 8. So it is performing the task whatever we recorded. So that's how the smart recorder will work. First, suppose I want to do some changes in it. So I need to select this task. See, if you see like here, this blue color, that means it has selected. Then you have to give the right click and click on edit. Even you can click edit here or here also. I am following this convention. So I am clicking edit. So here we can see. See the first statement, click on push 5. And the second statement, click on add button. Here and click on push button 3. And then click on push button equals to. So that is our task. So these are the steps we have performed, right? So those are the steps has been recorded here. So now I want to add 7 with 3. So now I want to edit this statement. So I am giving right click on the particular statement and clicking on edit. So here, if you go here, it is saying name. So here I am saying changing this one as 7. I am saving it now. Save and save. Now I am saving it. Okay. So here I am making it as 0 again. So now I am going to run it. See, let's check whether it will work or not. See, now it's clicked on 7, then 3, now it's became 10. That's how we can edit the recorded task. Whatever the task, whether it is smart recorder task or screen recorder task or web recorder task, irrespective of type, we can edit by using task editor. So this is about smart recorder. Okay.
Thanks for watching our videos. Please subscribe and click on bell icon to get regular notifications.